I will explain how to create a text from random letters in After Effects. You must have encountered this type of text animations in police movies, crypto, hacking, or digital themed productions. When we open the After Effects program, let's create a new composition by clicking New Composition. It's enough to create a 10-second image in 1920 by 1080 size. The background may be black. I click the OK button, and I get the text tool. We will write a text here. I'm writing sonography here. After typing the text, I select the selection tool and I need to center this text on the workspace. But first thing I need to do is put the anchor point in the center of it, so I can have better control over the text. I double click the anchor point button here by pressing the Ctrl key. Thus, it will have placed anchor point in the center. In the align window, I center my text both horizontally and vertically. The text is currently too large. I'm shrinking this text a little bit with the character panel. There may be disruptions at anchor point. We can do the same thing again. After we have written our text, we can now give it effects. I select the text layer here to give effect. I open the options by clicking the arrow next to it. Along with these options, you will see another option here called animate. There is a small icon next to it. When we click on this icon, it comes to another menu with various options. The option we will use for our effect in this menu will be the character offset option. When I click on it, new sub-options with different options appear. We will do this animation on these options. Now I press the Alt key and click the icon on the left of the character offset text. When I click on this icon, the expression panel will open and we can make some edits on this panel by typing text and writing code. It's not a long code. We will use the wiggle code here. I need to enter two values in parentheses. I enter 440. 4 is one parameter. 40 is another parameter. You can get different results by editing and playing on them. I click somewhere else on the timeline. As soon as I click, you will see that the characters have already changed. When I play the timeline, as you can see, a lot of meaningless characters will be lined up one after the other. After the movements of these characters, we will try to make the word begin to form and appear as a word at the end of the movement. The point where we'll do this and give this effect is the branch selector part. But before I get to this point, let me state one more small thing. The options here are also important. If you want them to consist of only letters, you should choose the option that exists now. In order to see Unicode characters, such as dollar sign, hyphen, asterisk, you need to select the option below. As you can see, a square bracket has now been opened. Looking elsewhere, you can also include special characters in this animation, such as colons, at sign, question marks, etc. Now let's come to the range selector part. The part where we will give the effect here is the offset part. When the offset is 0, random movements happen. When the offset is 100, we see the whole world as you can see, and we can create this animation by giving it a keyframe. Somewhere on the page, let's give offset keyframe and go a little further and set the offset value to 100%. Now when I play it, there will be a result like this. Random letters will start to loop starting from this keyframe. The whole world will be seen in this long period of time. If you think it's coming quickly, you can increase it a bit. Thus, we can think that it will come much more slowly. Now, if you learned how to make this animation, if you learned the logic, let's try to make the animation at the beginning of the video. I will not delay this effect. I added two images to the scene. One is the background, such a background. We can make it invisible. I'm going to make a little zoom into this background. I'm going to give it a zoom effect. Therefore, I will have given the scale effect. Here I'm giving the animation and enlarging it a little more. So there will be an animation like this. Now we will integrate the text animation here. Suppose this is Washington. We need to write Washington here. I select the text tool and let's type Washington. Now let's set it up. I put the text in the middle like this, and I want to add the date below it. Let me write the date. I also added the date. We'll make the arrangement soon. If you put a sound effect under it, it will be fine. After placing the sound effect, let's make the final edits. For example, Washington starts from here. By pressing the letter U, I can make the keyframes that I have given before appear, so I can regulate their speed better, quickly. Let the Washington text start from here. That is, from here, the sound effect already starts here. When Washington is over, or even before it ends, let the other part of the date begin. Let's make an animation like this. Let's see how it will be. It didn't suit the sound effect, so I'm expanding it a little more. I'm trying to spread it out a little more, so that it suits the sound effect. Let's check this way again. As you can see, we got what we wanted. Only the background image is coming very fast. Let's slow this down a bit. Then, we can come to the end of the video. Yes, I think it's okay. In this video, I showed you how to create words from random characters in After Effects, so we made this animation. If you like this video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Turn on notifications. I'll see you in the next video.